Game two about to get underway between your Samford Bulldogs as they've taken the first home game of the season against Iowa State. And now they're taking on the Murray State Racers as Taylor DeSellis, the starter for the Samford Bulldogs, winds and deals high for ball one to Brenna Fink for Murray State, the third baseman, coming in batting 486 on the season. 1-0 pitch. Called a strike, 1-1 the count. Fink, Ranberger, and Jessica Twaddle, the first three in the order, followed by Taylor Odom, Jocelyn Rogers, and Maggie Glass for Murray State. Levins, Kessel, and Downey, the bottom third of the Racers' order. Just underway in game two of the day for Samford University. First game of the day for Murray State as the count goes to 2-1. Samford with a 6-2 win over Iowa State as they led wire to wire in the victory. High pop-up in the infield left side where Lexi Higgins puts it away. First out of the inning, James Hardy with you. Our entire Samford Sports Network crew with us today. Executive producer Mike Grace along with our producer Jonathan McAfee and our various Samford students helping out with us throughout both games today. Kaylee Ranberger, the freshman batting 400, will take outside. 1-0. Samford at 3-8 now after their win over Iowa State. Murray State, a solid 8-2 start to come into the weekend. A two-game winning streak thanks to wins over Butler and McNeese State in Mobile last week as taking the rise ball high as Ranberger playing in center field, 2-0. Defensive alignment for Samford in the outfield, Shelby Mays in left field, Kelsey Royalty, the center fielder, and in right field, Abby Sweeney. 2-0 pitch, bunted at and missed by Ranberger, 2-1. Along the infield, Madison Couch, the third baseman, Lexi Higgins getting her second start of the season at short. Same for Abby Miranda, second start at second base, and Carson Spinks over at first. Little slapper foul to the left side, 2-2. Behind home plate, Hannah Trombley once again, like she was in game one. Samford with a 6-run bottom of the first inning against Iowa State, and that's all they would need as they coasted the rest of the way to a 6-2 win over the Big 12 foe, Iowa State Cyclones. Pitch on the way, swung on and missed, and a pitch on the outside corner as Ranberger goes down on strikes. Two away for Jessica Twaddle. We appreciate you joining us. Thanks to our YouTube live stream on the Samford Sports Network. That's where we'll be all season long here for the Samford Softball 2017 regular season. Looking to defend their SoCon Championship, their first ever championship from last year for the red, white, and blue of Samford U as taking a strike call is Twaddle, 0-1. It was a banner year, like we mentioned in Game 1, if you were with us for the state of Alabama in college softball last year with a Division II national champion, a Division I national runner-up, as well as a total of 5 NCAA regional teams. Pitch low and away, and Samford will take on Jacksonville State in a couple of weeks over in Oxford, Alabama. Also, will face Auburn and Alabama in the month of April. Already battled Troy University last weekend as far as in-state opponents is concerned, and they'll take on UAB 2 times, once on Sunday and then another down at the campus of UAB on April the 18th. Count it 2-1 to Jessica Twaddle, the senior, 12 of 30 from the plate with a couple of round trippers and 8 RBIs. Off-speed pitch in there. 2-2. Two innings of relief in the last game against Iowa State for Taylor DeSellis. Only gave up a run and struck out two, looking for a 1-2-3 inning, and misses high with the fastball, 3-2. Also mentioned in game one, a busy weekend for pretty much the entire sports scene across the Samford University campus. Actually, a couple of home games tomorrow. We'll have to mention a correction in the bottom of the first inning is a sharp liner foul to the left side. Still 3-2. Speaking of busy days, the SoCon with a busy softball day today. In addition to Samford's win earlier today on the softball diamond. As a grounder to the right side, slowly hit for Miranda, flips over to first base in time, and DeSellis gets her 1-2-3 inning. Nothing doing for Murray State in the first inning. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left on base as we are through a half inning of play. Murray State nothing, and Samford coming to bat on the Samford Sports Network.
These are the student athletes. This is where they train. These are their homes. This is where they become Rhodes Scholars and academic All-Americans. These are the athletes they've always admired. This is where champions are crowned and moments are made. This is the Southern Conference.
Game day brings out the best in all of us. Regions, every day is game day.
1-2-3 inning defensively for Samford in the top of the first inning as the red, white, and blue of Samford U will come to bat in the bottom of the first inning with Madison Couch, Shelby Mays, and Abby Sweeney leading off the top third of the lineup, followed by the middle third, Abby Miranda, Hannah Trombley, and Lauren Lewis. Bottom third of the order, Carson Spinks, Lexi Higgins, and Kelsey Royalty. Defensively for Murray State in the outfield, I have Levins in left field, Randberger in center, and in right field, Kessel. We'll get to the rest of the defensive alignment shortly as Mason Robinson, the right-handed pitcher and Murray State's starter, gets a called strike on Madison Couch, the third baseman. Madison Couch with two RBIs in the win over Iowa State earlier today as she'll bunt the 0-1 pitch foul, 0-2. Madison Couch, the replacement for Kelly Brister, who graduated last year. One of the top defensive third basemen in college softball last year. Also a really solid hitter over her Samford career as a tapper foul at the plate by Madison Couch. You can't emphasize this enough as far as just the story of Samford softball and really 2017 being a transition era as far as the on-field talent to a new era. As the 0-2 is high on the fastball from Mason Robinson. As you're going from the era with Molly Hansen and Abby Adams from 2014 and 15, the 1-2. That's a changeup high, 2-2. Also, Megan Dowdy, that was a 3-4-year starter for this program, out and out, fielding at the top of the order in the batting order. Liner right back to the box. We're stabbing it. Out of the air was Robinson. One up, one down for Mason Robinson. Taking a look at the Murray State infield. Fink over at third base. The shortstop, Maggie Glass, and at second base is Erica Downey. Patrolling first is Jessica Twaddle. As the grounder over to third with the throw across from Fink in time as two up, two down for Samford here in the bottom of the first inning. So Shelby Mays retired on a ground ball. As she's 0 for 1.
Abby Sweeney
to the plate. 290 the batting average, one home run, and eight RBIs. Takes the fastball right down the middle for strike one. Behind home plate is Jocelyn Rogers, the catcher. That's catching for Murray State's Mason Robinson. 0-1. Tapped weakly to third. A fair ball for Fink as she'll throw low, but scooped out by Twaddle at first. A quick inning for Robinson as Samford also goes down in order in the first inning. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left on bases. We're quickly through one. Your score is no score, in fact, between Murray State and Samford as you're watching Samford softball on the Samford Sports Network.
Did you order a pizza?
Pizza drone! Get down! Pizza drone!
Are you kidding me? Gimmicks don't make better pizza. Our people and ingredients make better pizza.
Get Papa John's Ultimate Meats Pizza with five different meats on pan or large crust, only $11.
We're more than a pizza company. We're a pizza family. Papa John's.
Big day tomorrow at the Pete Hanna Center as both Samford men's and women's basketball will close out their home schedule. First for women's basketball, as head coach Mike Morris and his Bulldogs have just one remaining date on the regular season schedule, and it's senior day tomorrow. And, of course, the doubleheader that I mentioned as the women's team hosts Mercer at 2 o'clock while the men get the Citadel Bulldogs at 6 o'clock. The game against Mercer for Scott Padgett's squad on Monday at 6 o'clock as Blake Gardner will have the call of both of those games on our new home for Samford men's basketball, 99-1, the game here in the Magic City. You can get your tickets by phone, though, if you want to attend at 205-726-DOGS. That's 726-3647 or online at sanfordsports.com. Top of the second inning for Murray State at the plate is Taylor Odom behind in the count 0-1. Fastball from DeSalis, outside corner, 0-2. James Hardy with you. We appreciate you watching us on our YouTube feed and our Samford University Athletics YouTube page. Samford looking for two wins today after defeating Iowa State 6-2. Pitch low, 1-2. Murray State with their first game of the day so far. The meeting for Samford against Iowa State, the first in program history. The 1-2, that tails low as well, 2-2. For Samford and Murray State, this is the second meeting here at the Samford softball field in the last three seasons. Grounder foul wide of the third base coach's box. The last time that these two teams met was in 2015 as Samford came up with a 6-5 come from behind victory thanks to a walk-off home run from Caitlin Bice. Check that, two home runs for Caitlin Bice in that game. A off-speed pitch in there for a called strike three as Taylor Odom goes down looking. Two strikeouts for DeSellis, one out in the inning. Overall in this series, Murray State leads 3-2. Samford has won the first meeting of this series back in 2010, and then the most recent meeting 2 years ago. And then Murray State has sandwiched that with a three-game winning streak in the series. High pop-up foul to the left side for Jocelyn Rogers as it goes out of play, 0-1. Rogers, the senior, 258. Two home runs and 12 RBIs. 9 of 10 starters for Murray State returning from last year's squad. Pitch high on the rise ball from DeSellis, 1-1. Kara Amundsen in her fifth season as the head coach for Murray State, 127-103 in five seasons. Liner into left center field. That will get down for a base hit as Royalty ranges over into left center and does a good job getting the ball back in and limiting Rogers to a single. Saw that from Iowa State in game one for Samford today as Lauren Lewis had a similar hit to right field that one hopped the wall but only managed to single. As a good defensive play from Royalty to hustle over into left center field and hold Rogers to the single. So Maggie Glass to the plate, one of the top power hitters in the OVC. Two home runs and five RBIs so far with a .296 average on the year. Fastball in there, strike one. Mentioned about Iowa State. Murray State playing most of their games on the road. In fact, have not played a home game so far as of now. Top of the second inning is DeCellis making the start after closing out the ball game against Iowa State with two innings of just one hit ball and allowed just one run. Count it 1-1. High fly ball hit well into left center field as Royalty goes over, and she'll make the catch on the warning track for out number two. Thought that had a chance to get out of the park for Maggie Glass, who's, as we mentioned, one of the top home run hitters in the OVC, but Shelby Mays and Royalty got over with Royalty making the grab for the second out.
Now batting the left fielder,
Kayla Levins to the plate. Another senior in this starting lineup. Five seniors starting today in the batting order for Murray State. .300 the batting average for Levins. No home runs and five RBIs. Pops one up right in front of us that goes foul into the stands. 9 of 10 starters returning from the 2016 squad. For the Racers that have won 8 of their first 10 games coming into this weekend. For Levins, a senior out of Jacksonville, Florida, has started every game so far, already with 3 multi-hit games on the year. A 2-time NFCA All-America Scholar Athlete fouls one off left side. Check that, a 3-time NFCA All-America Scholar Athlete. A 4-year starter for Murray State. Levins, a .274 batter her freshman year, .291 as a sophomore, and then still a respectable .277 last year in 55 starts. .02 lined into the glove of the shortstop Lexi Higgins, who ranges to her right and makes the catch to end the inning. So DeSellis gets out of a little bit of trouble. No runs, one hit, no errors, and one left on base. We go to the bottom of the second inning. No score between Murray State and Samford. As you're watching Samford softball on the Samford Sports Network.
Human beings can be hungry anytime they please. Maybe you messed up and didn't eat enough lunch. Perhaps dinner is very far away. It doesn't matter. Come to Arby's and solve your hunger problems with dollar sliders, cookies, small size fries, drinks, and shakes, each for a dollar from 2 to 5. P.M., not A.M. Arby's, we have the meat.
At Express Oil Change and Tire Engineers, we believe in service.
Maintenance service, tire service, repair service.
And most importantly, customer service.
We believe in treating our customers with respect and integrity while offering all the services you need for your car.
Most of all, at Express Oil Change and Tire Engineers,
we believe in keeping cars on the road, keeping families safe,
and keeping you coming back whenever the need arises.
Samford fans, have your birthday with the Bulldogs. Enjoy food, fun, and Samford Sports as you celebrate your birthday at a Samford Athletics event. Spots are available for a number of upcoming dates for both Bulldog baseball and softball. For more information, contact the Samford Spirit Office at 726-4348. That's 726-4348. 1-800-878-4648. James Hardy with you for another season of Samford University softball here on the Samford Sports Network. You're viewing us live on our YouTube stream at Samford University Athletics YouTube page, where we'll be throughout the 2017 softball season. As Samford tries to defend their 2016 SoCon championship. Abby Miranda leads off as she'll take strike one, 0-1. Miranda, Trombley, and Lewis going up against Mason Robinson, who has a 6-1 start to the season from the circle. As Robinson gets the fastball in there, 0-2. This is the seventh start of the season for the senior pitcher. 2.31 ERA for Robinson as Miranda fouls it off to the right side. 36 and a third innings pitch coming into the game for Robinson. She's allowed 46 hits, 17 runs, of which 12 are earned, has walked just four batters and has struck out 19. 0-2. Tapped at the plate, foul, still 0-2. Mason Robinson, one of the top pitchers in the OVC, looking to dethrone Jacksonville State as the OVC champions. 0-2, grounded foul about 3 feet wide to the left, our left of the third base bag. Robinson, a 6'2 senior from Lewis Center, Ohio, was a second team All-OVC selection last year. Also earned Pitcher of the Week honors late in the season as a liner goes right to the first baseman Twaddle for out number one. Last season, Robinson 19-16 with an ERA of 1.99 in 36 starts. Struck out 119 batters but walked 61. Doesn't allow a whole lot of home run balls, allowed just 8 last year. Coming to the plate, Trombley will take her first pitch from Robinson a little bit inside. In 2015 for Robinson, 26 starts allowed just 2 round trippers. 1-0 to Trombley. Fouls one back to the screen. 1-1. Robinson likes to go with the fastball, and you look at the frame, the 6'2 frame that she has. Definitely an intimidating presence as far as Robinson's concerned from the circle. Off speed pitch low, 2-1 to the Samford catcher. Had an RBI double in the first inning in that 6-run rally against Iowa State earlier today. Takes a fastball outside corner. That had some pop to it for Robinson, 2-2. Murray State wearing the navy blue tops, also the gold numbers and the gold letters, the 2-2. Grounded right back to Robinson as she'll throw a little low, and that's scooped up nicely over by Twaddle at first base. Wasn't exactly expecting a 2-foot dribbler that time, but gets the job done for Robinson on the 1-3 putout. Two away for Lauren Lewis, the designated player, who had one of her best offensive games of the season against Iowa State with a couple of hits and also a couple of RBIs. Lewis grounds one on the first pitch, left side to the shortstop, Glass scoops and throws to first in time in another 1-2-3 inning for Mason Robinson for Murray State. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left on base for Samford University as we're through two full innings of play. It's Samford nothing and Murray State nothing as we go to the third on the Samford Sports Network. balmy 78 degrees under partly cloudy skies here from the campus of Samford University in the magic city of Birmingham, Alabama. James Hardy with you on the Samford Sports Network as you're watching us on our YouTube feed for today. We'll be back with you on Sunday to close out the weekend as UAB will take on your red, white, and blue of Samford U for the first of two games this season. Scheduled for around a 3:30 start here at the campus of Samford University Sunday afternoon as the first pitch drops low for ball one. Samford baseball underway down in Tallahassee as they're taking on the Florida State Seminoles, and Florida State with the upper hand so far, up 9-2 in the third. Back to action here in the top of the third as Leah Kessel swings and misses at the 1-0, 1-1. It's Kessel, Downey, and Fink due up. Swing and a miss at a pitch that sails outside, 1-2. Furman closes out their day today with a couple of victories as they get in game two of the Buffalo Wild Wings Classic, a 7-4 win over Sacred Heart. 1-2 pitch low and away, 2-2. Also to go along with a 1-0 win earlier today against Toledo. The 2-2. Swing and a miss as going down on strikes is Leah Kessel. Three strikeouts, one each inning so far for Taylor DeCellis. Erica Downey, the second baseman, will get her first swing of the day. 217, the batting average is Downey has started every game so far at the junior. No home runs and four RBIs. Pitch nearly in, in fact, does come in and barely grazes, but good enough to put Erica Downey at first base on the HBP. Second base runner of the game for Murray State as we're in the third inning with one out as Downey at first base. Back to the top of the order and Brenna Fink, who's 0-for-1 with a pop out to the shortstop her last time up. DeCellis misses low. Curveball, 1-0. Fink, a sophomore, two sophomores in the lineup, five seniors in the lineup offensively for Murray State, not including Robinson, who's also a senior from the circle. As Fink will take outside, 2-0. The Samford Bulldogs coming in at 3-8 on the season. Snapped a three-game losing streak after losing four or five games down at Troy last weekend in the Trojan Classic. Split two games with Longwood, lost a single game to Troy, and then lost two games to Jacksonville. 2-0. A hit and run tapped foul to the right side, 2-1. Smart play by Carson Spinks to field it in foul territory. Especially with the runner going as it's no score. We're in the top of the third inning as we're moving right along in this one. A grounder to the right side. This will be a fair ball for Carson Spinks, who will tag out Fink coming over to first bases. There will be now two outs and essentially a glorified sacrifice as Downey advances to second base on the play. So the possible go-ahead run now in scoring position for Kaylee Ranberger, who struck out swinging in the first inning. Taylor DeCellis for Samford looking to get out of trouble here in the third inning. Fastball high and away. Count it 1-0. picture-perfect weather, especially for late February here on the home opening day for Samford University softball, as a swing and a miss at the 1-0 evens the count at 1-1. Rain forced the postponement of what would have been the home opener Tuesday against Kennesaw State. A makeup date has not been announced as of yet. The 1-1 lined in the center field, and that will be caught as perfectly positioned that time, and only having to move a couple of steps was Kelsey Royalty as she makes the line drive catch. So one left in scoring position, no runs, no hits, no errors, and one left at second base. So we're through 2.5 innings play, no score on the Samford Sports Network.
General Shale makes your great outdoors even better with big savings on its outdoor living collection. Everything you need to create your own backyard fire pit, outdoor fireplace, General Shale delivers to your home and can recommend a contractor. Or offers easy-to-follow instructions to do it yourself. Save money now on backyard fun with General Shale's complete outdoor living collection. Hurry, your great outdoors is waiting for you.
No score. We're already through 2.5 innings play as we go to the bottom of the third inning. Samford still looking for their first base runner in the game after scoring 6 runs against the Iowa State Cyclones in game 1 of the day for the red, white, and blue of Samford U. The bottom third of the order, Carson Spinks, Lexi Higgins, and Kelsey Royalty are due up for the Bulldogs. Carson Spinks playing first base today, the junior out of Hogansville, Georgia. Looking for her first hit of the afternoon, but did score a run against Iowa State in the win earlier today. Lines one on the first pitch into the Samford bullpen left side. Carson Spinks, we mentioned, sparely used last year in 2016, just 17 games played a year ago, but played in 47 games as a true freshman and had a .270 batting average. The 0-1 low. Somebody didn't mention part of that senior class last year, Caitlin Bice. Great all-around player, solid defender at first base as a grounder up the middle, fielded by Downey at second, throws almost wide of the bag, but a good job at first by Twaddle to make the stab for out number one. And you look at that senior class last year that had the likes of Callie Brister that we mentioned, Molly Hansen ditto to that as well. Megan Dowdy in the outfield, same deal there. Caitlin Bice over at first base. You're talking a lot of leadership, folks, and a lot of production that you have to replace from last year to this year. But there, I saw a lot of promise, and I'm sure you did too, earlier today with Samford's performance in that win over Iowa State. A lot of potential going forward. Lexi Higgins takes ball one. And takes a strike call. And one of those players in the 2016 squad that definitely played a role at the plate, Lexi Higgins, was a first baseman, also utility player as a freshman 2 years ago, and then had to move over to replace Abby Adams, a four-year starter at shortstop, and did a pretty solid job as the shortstop defensively, and also hit 9 homers last year. Higgins up 2-1. Now even at 2-2 as she fouls it off back to the screen. Not doing so well this year. 2 of 25 coming into the day. And after game one, now 2 for 27 from the plate. 2-2. Good eyes, she'll take up and in to load the count full 3-2. Lexi Higgins, get this, already 3 grand slams in her career with the Samford Bulldogs. and one this season so far. She'll hit a high pop-up into shallow center. Second baseman Downey into shallow center makes the catch. Two away for Kelsey Royalty. Started 47 games last year, played 55 as well as a true freshman, hit .296 last year, and coming into this game, .281 with a home run and four RBIs. Royalty, a sophomore out of Marietta, Georgia, takes low for ball one. A lot of players now on this roster coming from the Atlanta area in the state of Georgia. Annalyn Yantis from Powder Springs, Kelsey Royalty at the plate from just outside of Atlanta and Marietta. Strike call, 1-1. Carson Spinks as well from Hogansville, Georgia. The 1-1 is dribbled softly over to first, where Twaddle throws to the second baseman covering not in time, as Royalty, give credit to her, hustles down that first base line to keep the inning alive on an infield single. A bang-bang play as Twaddle did a nice job getting over to that softball, and then Downey didn't do a bad job herself trying to get over to the first base bag from the second base position to cover. As I'm blocked from the discussion as far as the bang-bang play, as the call will stand on the field as Royalty does make it into first on a two-out single. I was mentioning about the contributions of the Peach State players, Hannah Trombley from Dallas, Georgia. Also, you're talking at the plate, Madison Couch, a sophomore from Locust Grove, Georgia, is the fastball outside for Mason Robinson. Taylor DeCellis, the starting pitcher out of Powder Springs, Georgia, so a lot of Georgia influence now. And Catherine Jackson, another Georgia product that has started off and on this season, also a Powder Springs, Georgia product. Madison Couch at the plate, lined out to Mason Robinson in the first inning, up 2-0 on the count, and now swings and misses, 2-1. Shadows starting to dominate the outfield on the playing surface. Liner into the glove of the second baseman Downey as she ranges to her right and makes the catch to end the inning. So two lineouts for Madison Couch on the day, and the lineout to second ends the inning for Samford as we're through three, no score as both teams, no runs, one hit, and no errors through three. We'll go to the top of the fourth, nothing on the Samford Sports Network.
The madness begins here. Make sure you're at the U.S. Cellular Center in Asheville, North Carolina, March 2nd through 6th for the 2017 SoCon Basketball Championships presented by General Shale. You don't want to miss the action as your favorite SoCon teams compete for a championship and a berth in the NCAA tournament. Book your travel and tickets by logging on to SoConTravel.com or by contacting the U.S. Cellular Center box office. Madness begins here. Get your tickets today.
This is Lauren. These are her first roommates, her first car, and her very first health insurance plan, Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama. Even at her age, she's not taking her health for granted. Her affordable health plan includes a routine annual checkup, apps, and programs that fit her lifestyle. Lauren may be just starting out, but with us, she's already got peace of mind. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama. We cover what matters. Find out how we can cover you for...
The iconic Harlem Globetrotters are coming to town with their unrivaled family show featuring some of the greatest athletes on the planet. With incredible ball handling wizardry, amazing rim-rattling dunks, side-splitting comedy, and unequaled on-court fan interaction, this must-see event is guaranteed to entertain the whole family. Join us here on campus Sunday, March the 12th, or Sunday, March the 19th, inside the Pete Hanna Center to be a part of the show. For ticket information, just visit samfordsports.com/tickets. Taylor DeCellis in her fourth inning of work for this game. Gets a called strike on Jessica Twaddle, 0-1. Liner on one hop right to Higgins, left sided. Short throws across the diamond, out number one. Moving right on along in this second game. Samford looking for two wins today, looking for their first two-game winning streak of the season. Coming off of a 6-2 victory, at least in my mind, their best overall performance of the season against Iowa State. Taylor Odom looking for her first hit, struck out looking to begin the second inning, gets ahead in the count 1-0. Check swing and a fly ball down the right field line, foul territory, and that's out of play, 1-1. Jocelyn Rogers is on deck for Murray State. The Racers out of Murray, Kentucky. Saw them here a couple of years ago. In fact, one had a good season in 2015. A couple of good teams facing off that day about this time 2 years ago. Ground ball left side for Higgins. Fields on a couple of hops and then throws high over the first baseman, Carson Spinks. And that gets into the dugout and will allow Odom to reach second base. Samford did not commit an error in game number one today. But the overthrow, the first error of the afternoon, will put a runner at second base with just one out. Through the first six games of the season, defense was an issue for the Bulldogs. 14 errors in those first six games, but since then, including this error in this game, only three errors. Something I mentioned in game one, something you want to look for in the big picture with this squad. How does this team improve over the course of the season? And the first pitch, off-speed pitch, a changeup. Will miss low and away to Jocelyn Rogers, 1-0. One thing you got to look for is pitching and, like I mentioned, defense as well. 1-0. Just inside, maybe low as well, 2-0. Thought Gray Adams was rock solid in the circle in game one. Taylor DeCellis not doing too bad herself in game one. And also doing a good job as well so far in game two right now. Misses low, 3-0, however, to the Murray State catcher, Jocelyn Rogers. Runner at second. That's Taylor Odom, one out. DeCellis misses low to Rogers. Ball four as two runners are on, one out for Maggie Glass, one of, like I mentioned, the top power hitters in the OVC, a veteran infielder. Already two multi-RBI games coming into the weekend. A preseason first-team All-OVC selection last year and was a first-team All-OVC selection in 2015 as a sophomore, had 53 RBIs along with 16 round-trippers as a sophomore. Definitely has potential to leave the yard, so you got to be smart if you're the young true freshman and Taylor DeCellis out in the circle. Grounder, that's foul. Watch out over there, head coach Mandy Burford, and she's able to get out of the way of that screaming ground ball. 0-1. Mentioned in game one, Mandy Burford celebrated a birthday earlier this week. Also a little bit under the weather, but gutting it out today. The 0-1. Taken high. I know from my end, I've done a baseball Division II baseball doubleheader with a cold, and I can tell you that's not too pleasant, especially when you're doing it solo. Couldn't imagine what it's like coaching-wise. I'm sure although I'm sure you're just mentally blocking it out. Grounder over to third as Couch misplaced it past the third base bag, and everybody's going to be safe. Tricky hop for Madison Couches. That'll be the second error of the inning to keep the rally going for the Racers as Odom to third, Rogers to second, and Maggie Glass reaches over at first base. Still waiting to see, and now they're going to put an error on the board. So Madison Couch with the E5 on the scoring on that last play. As the bases loaded, one out. Kayla Levins lined out to short her last time up as she'll foul the first pitch off back to the screen. Big sequence of events in this ball game. We're in the top of the fourth inning, no score. In this type of ball game, every play becomes critical. Third weekend of the regular season in college softball. Samford looking for their first two-game winning streak of the season. The 0-1, high pop-up, but that will be out of play. Third base side, 0-2. And I mentioned earlier, looking for the progression as a team, offensively, defense, but especially defensively and pitching-wise, as we go over the course of the season, especially as we approach conference play in about a month. The 0-2. Pop up into shallow center field. Could be trouble as that will fall in front of the center fielder royalty as the throw to second base not in time. As coming home from third to score is Odom as Murray State takes a 1-0 lead. That'll be an RBI single for Kayla Levins as the RBI for her on the season, her sixth. Bases remain loaded as Rogers to third, Glass to second, and Levinson for Leah Kessel, who struck out her last time up. For Mandy Burford, you're looking for the non-conference schedule to see how this team grows. And this is the type of growing situation, especially for a true freshman pitcher. You're looking to see what Taylor DeCellis is made of mentally, what her poise is from the circle. Bases loaded is the infield coming in with just one out. Leah Kessel, the right fielder, will take low for ball one. The run that scored unearned, by the way. It's two errors in the inning defensively along the infield for the red, white, and blue of Samford U. High pop-up right side on the infield. That'll be an infield fly as the catch is made by Miranda at second base. So the runners stay put. Bases remain loaded, but two outs now for the number nine hitter, Erica Downey. Now, if Taylor DeCellis can get this out, I'd consider that a job well done considering the circumstances. Fastball in the outside corner for strike one. 0-1. Outfield straightaway. Infield playing back up the middle and playing along the bags at the corners. The 0-1. Fastball outside. Indiana and Iowa State are done for the day. Samford will play tomorrow, Murray State and Indiana. Grounder back to the circle is fielding and throwing DeCellis to first base in time as she does a very nice job getting out of some trouble with limited damage on the board. So that'll do it for Murray State in the fourth inning. There was one run, one hit, a pair of errors, and the bases left loaded. So we are halfway home in this one. Murray State 1 and Samford nothing as you're watching Samford softball on the Samford Sports Network.
I think we should have taken a left at the river.
Tarzan, no. Where Tarzan go?
Tarzan does not know where Tarzan go.
Hey, excuse me. Do you know where the waterfall is? Waterfall?
No. Me, Tarzan.
King of Jungle.
I know you wanted to.
If you're a couple, you fight over directions. It's what you do. If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to Geico. It's what you do.
You have to do that right in my ear.
Discover new things is good. For example, you may discover that the best bank in town isn't a bank.
Good job by Taylor DeSellis getting out of some trouble. Did allow an unearned run, but keeps Samford very much in this ballgame at 1-0. In the bottom of the fourth inning, James Hardy and the rest of our Samford Sports Network family here with us today on a big home opening weekend for your red, white, and blue of Samford U on a bright, sunny, and unusually warm afternoon here in the Magic City. Shelby Mays, Abby Sweeney, and Abby Miranda will try and tie or take the lead in this inning for Samford as the bunt by Mays foul behind the left-handed batter's box. Shelby Mays, a local product from about 20-25, maybe a 30-minute drive, depending on traffic north of here in Morris, Alabama. A few minutes north of downtown Birmingham. The 0-1 grounded to the second baseman. A good field by Downey, but the throw is not in time. I'll tell you, that was a great play, just to even have a chance to get Mays out over by Erica Downey. But, I mean, you see the speed right there by Shelby Mays as she gets on with a leadoff single. Second hit of the day. Second base runner for the Samford Bulldogs. As Abby Sweeney looking for her first hit of the afternoon. 0-1 in this game. Takes low for ball one. My word for the day, improvement. Certainly saw that all the way around in game one, especially in the pitching circle where Gray Adams and Taylor DeSellis rock solid today. Pitches low. And when you look at that 2-8 start the first 2 weeks, like I mentioned in game one, 5-1 run losses, 3 extra inning losses, they aren't far from a decent record, but you're positioning yourself if you're talking SoCon or OVC for later on in the year, is the 2-0 fastball in there by Mason Robinson for a strike. And we even saw last year with, let's say, Samford and Jacksonville State, slow starts, but they dominated the SoCon and the OVC respectively and turned it on, won their conference tournaments, and were able to get in with the automatic bid. Liner to Downey for the first out of the inning. Shelby Mays was able to scamper back into first base. Abby Miranda's at the plate. Especially with Samford last year, they were almost in that at-large territory as far as RPI, especially late in the season in the top 50 for about the last 3 to 4 weeks of the season as a foul ball to the right side out of play. But when you're talking the Samfords and the Murray States and the Jacksonville States and you get deep into the season and you have good seasons like Samford and Jack State did last year, grounder to the third baseman throws across the diamond as going on the pitch was Mays for out number two as Fink will get the out at first. So 5-3 put out, two away, just like a sacrifice as Shelby Mays, the tying run in scoring position. So when you're a program, even like a Murray State that had a really good season a couple of seasons ago with 38 wins, unless basically you're in the top 40, you've got to win the conference tournament. First pitch outside for ball one. Hannah Trombley at the plate certainly has the power to put Samford on top. Fouls one off, still looking for the first home run of the season is Hannah Trombley. In fact, we almost saw it against Iowa State in that first inning. Had a double that was off the top of the wall just to the left of straightaway center field. Robinson with the 1-1. Misses just high. 2-1. By the way, Chris Lyles at home plate today. Nate Ayers over at first and Mike Lett at third are our umpires for this game. 2-1 is lined to the shortstop where Glass fields and throws to first in time to end the inning. So the first legitimate run scoring opportunity for Samford goes awry. A leadoff single is wasted in the fourth inning. No runs on one hit, no errors, and a runner left in scoring position. We're through four. Murray State 1 and Samford nothing as you're watching Samford softball on the Samford Sports Network. Scott Padgett's Bulldogs return to the Pete Hanna Center tomorrow night for a 6 p.m. start against the Citadel Bulldogs. And it's senior night as the Dogs' lone senior, Terry Brutus, will be honored in pregame ceremonies. Look for details and get your tickets at sanfordsports.com. And come early for senior night tomorrow night with your Samford Bulldogs. And, of course, our good friend and a big congratulations to Samford alum now, Blake Gardner, as he graduated this past May, and now the play-by-play voice succeeding our very good friend, Mike Grace, who's doing the PA today as the voice of Samford football, basketball, and baseball. He'll also be on the call of the regular season finale for Samford men's basketball at Mercer on Monday. And then, of course, we'll talk about later, conference tournament play begins next week in the SoCon. We're in the top of the fifth inning, 1-0. Samford trailing is Fink, Ranberger, and Twaddle. The three going up against DeCellis for Murray State as the count at 1-1. Pitch from DeCellis. Taken low and away, 2-1. One run, two hits, no errors for Murray State. No runs, two hits, a pair of errors for Samford. Line drive into center. That drops down for a base hit. Brenna Fink with her first hit as she's 1-for-3. Kaylee Ranberger 0-for-2 with a strikeout and a line out to center. We'll get her third at bat today. The racer, third baseman. A pitching-slash-defensive-oriented game in this one so far with just now five hits between the two squads. Wouldn't be completely shocked if we see a sacrifice situation here to try and give Murray State some insurance as the bunt down in front of home plate. As they'll say, it is an out apparently called at home plate. On what will be batter's interference, apparently. Still a little confusion out in the field as having to go back to first base is Fink. As I believe what happened that time is that you had the initial contact of the bat on the bunt, and then once the batter Ranberger got out of the plate, it hit the bat again, and so it's a double hit, and therefore base and out. A two unassisted on the scorebook. So one away. Runner has to go back to first base as one out for Jessica Twaddle as the count goes to 0-1. So that's a break for Samford that time as DeSellis gets an out without a runner getting into scoring position. Bunt foul to the right side, 0-2. Taylor Odom on deck. So far, a great outing in the start for Taylor DeSellis as she has given up an unearned run through almost five innings, for a little over four innings of play. We'll get to her numbers here shortly as the pitch low as the snap throw down, and that's not in time. Taylor DeSellis, 4 1/3 innings so far, has allowed 3 hits, 1 unearned run with a walk and 3 strikeouts. 1-2 to Jessica Twaddle. We'll take away, does Twaddle, 2-2. Twaddle, the senior out of Franklin, Tennessee. Already 5 multi-hit games, so she'll pop one up to right center, has some carries at the track as Royalty, and that's misplayed between Sweeney and Royalty, as everybody's safe. And moving up to second base will be Fink. An example of the growing pains that we're seeing is Royalty, albeit in her second year as a starter on this squad, just starting her first few games as the center fielder. She and Abby Sweeney misplay that fly ball as everybody is safe on what will be a single for Jessica Twaddle. What should have been the second out of the inning is a fly ball to left field, hit well, but camping under it. And now coming in is Shelby Mays for out number 2, as she'll throw back to first, and it gets wide of everybody, as that'll allow a couple of runners to move up. So as it stands, a run is going to come home to score, as we're going to have a conference between our three umpires, Chris Lyles, Nate Ayers, and Mike Lett. As you had the fly out in left field for the second out, and the throw sailed over second base by Shelby Mays, as you had the three-man umpiring crew discussing this last play. Head coach Mandy Burford coming out to contest the ruling, but it will stand as another error on the board for Samford defensively on an E7 will allow Fink to come home to score. Twaddle will advance to third as the throw got out of play. 3 errors and so far 2 unearned runs on the board as a fly ball hit well into left center field for Rogers. That will go over the fence for a 2-run homer. Jocelyn Rogers with the round tripper, her third of the season in RBIs, number 13 and 14, as Murray State has built a cushion now up 4-0. So 3 errors so far today. 2 of the runs today earned for Taylor DeSellis out of the 4 total runs given up, as we'll have time called in a pitching change as Gray Adams will come in to replace Taylor DeSellis. We'll take the timeout and be back after this on as you're watching Samford Softball on the Samford Sports Network.
Game day brings out the best in all of us.
Tires. Every day is game day.
Human beings can be hungry anytime they please. Maybe you messed up and didn't eat enough lunch. Perhaps dinner is very far away. It doesn't matter. Come to Arby's and solve your hunger problems with dollar sliders, cookies, small size fries, drinks, and shakes, each for a dollar from 2 to 5. P.M., not A.M. Arby's, we have the...
Game one starter Gray Adams comes back to the circle to relieve Taylor DeCellis as Murray State has put three on the board in the top of the fifth inning to take a 4-0 lead, thanks in part to a two-run homer to left center field by Jocelyn Rogers. Also, a throwing error in left field by Shelby Mays allowed the first run of the inning to score. So far, two runs today unearned in this one. Three total errors for Samford's defense against Murray State after going errorless against Iowa State. Maggie Glass 0-for-2 looking for her first hit. As Gray Adams behind in the count misses with the 1-0, 2-0 the count. Top of the fifth inning, still an opportunity for Samford to battle back, but outs becoming a premium once you get to the bottom half of the inning and when Samford comes to bat. Glass ahead in the count, 3-0. Mentioned it in game one, the lack of walks and errors allowed the Samford pitching to limit the damage that the two home runs given up could have caused, as they were both solo shots. However, three errors and a two-run homer, a big difference in the Racers' lead. 3-1 now the count on Maggie Glass. Pitch misses inside for ball four. Errors, of course, never a good thing. Of course, a home run, always the big play, but I've talked about it throughout the years. It's not always the big plays that do you in. Sometimes it's the nickel and dime plays that add up over time that can also cost you as equally as the big plays. High pop up the infield as the catch made on the right side by Carson Spinks to retire Kayla Levins. However, the damage is done with three runs on a couple of hits. There was another error and a runner left on base. So we are through 4.5 innings of play. It's now Murray State 4 and Samford nothing as we'll take the timeout on the Samford Sports Network.
Order a pizza.
Pizza John! Get down! Pizza John!
Are you kidding me? Gimmicks don't make better pizza. Our people and ingredients make better pizza.
Get Papa John's Ultimate Meats Pizza with five different meats on pan or large crust, only $11.
Or more than a pizza company. Or a pizza family.
Four to nothing, Murray State with the lead. We're in the bottom of the fifth inning. James Hardy with you on the Samford Sports Network via our YouTube stream for today's doubleheader for Samford softball home opener for the red, white, and blue of Samford U. Mentioned about the SoCon basketball tournament as March Madness closely coming to us now as we're about a week away from the SoCon championship up in Asheville. There's a grounder on the first pitch to Robinson off the bat of Lauren Lewis as she'll ground out into the 1-3 put out. One away. The madness of college basketball's postseason begins in Asheville, North Carolina, March the 2nd through the 6th with the 2017 SoCon Men's and Women's Basketball Championships presented by General Shale. An action-packed week at the U.S. Cellular Center, the natural beauty and nightlife of Asheville, North Carolina, and events and activities designed for fans of all ages combined to make the SoCon tournament one of the top conference tournament experiences in the country. Carson speaks batting as she'll foul off the 0-1. 0-2 the count. For information on tickets, hotels, special events, and Asheville discounts and attractions, log on to SoConTravel.com or contact the Samford Ticket Office. Foul ball back to the screen. You can contact the Samford Ticket Office at 726-DOGS or reach them online at SanfordSports.com/tickets. Robinson with the 0-2. Fouled off back to the screen. A great first game for Samford as they defeated Iowa State and showed the potential I think this team has later on in the season, winning 6-2, but so far showing the growing pains of a young team as well in this one with three errors, trailing 4-0. The 1-2, taken low, 2-2. The Murray State Racers 8-2 coming into this game, up 4-0. The 2-2, grounded weakly to the left side for Glass, gobbles and throws the first in time. Two up, two down as Mason Robinson has retired 5 in a row in the circle for the Racers. Earlier in the midweek in SoCon play and softball action, mentioned Samford's postponement from Tuesday, but light action on Wednesday as a fly ball right at the right fielder Kessel as Higgins has retired to end the inning. So another quiet inning for Samford offensively as Mason Robinson retires the Bulldogs in order. We're through 5. Murray State 4 and Samford nothing as you're watching Samford softball on the Samford Sports Network.
If you're entering a Division I college or university on or after August 1st of 2016, there are some new academic requirements you need to know.
First, you have to graduate high school within 4 consecutive years from the start of 9th grade. And in those 4 years, you have to pass 16 core courses.
Next, your 16 core courses must be taken in a specific area of study at a specific time during high school.
Your 16 core courses will determine your core GPA, which must be 2.3 or higher to be eligible to practice, compete, or receive an athletic scholarship during your freshman year in college.
10 of those 16 have to be taken before your 7th semester. Those 10 courses are locked in, meaning you can't retake them to improve your GPA.
You must also earn a combined ACT and SAT score that matches your core course GPA on the Division I sliding scale.
It's important to build a team that you can depend on for guidance and support, so go talk to your guidance counselor and ask them to join your team.
We all were in your shoes just a few years ago, so we know what it takes to become a Division I student athlete.
But more importantly, we know what it means to make our dreams become a reality.
Top of the 6th inning, moving along nicely in this second game of the home schedule for the Samford Bulldogs. 1-0 on the home schedule so far after defeating Iowa State out of the Big 12, but not such a great, at least, result right now, but still some softball left to be played as we're in the 6th inning as a good Murray State team leads 4-0. The Racers, as I mentioned, off to an 8-2 start, have already beaten Mercer as far as the SoCon competition on Murray State's non-conference schedule. As they made the trip to Macon, Georgia to open season, did Murray State, and performed very well in that weekend as well. Time to flip the lineup card over as Leah Kessel, 0-2, will take strike one against Gray Adams. It was scoreless through 3, and then Murray State scored a run, an unearned run in the 4th, and then 3 more runs, 2 of those off of a Jocelyn Rogers 2-run shot to left center in the fifth. Kessel even in the count, 1-1. Curveball misses outside and low, 2-1. Kessel, a sophomore, 9 games played coming in to this one. Has started 6 of 10 games this year. Good location by Adams on the inside corner, 2-2. Kessel, a sophomore, as we mentioned, from Luce Creek, Missouri. Already 2 multi-hit games this year with a .313 average. Grounder right side, fielded nicely as the throw to first base is in time for out number one as a defensive substitution for Samford University as the new second baseman, Whitney Hinton, coming in to make the play. And moving from second to shortstop is Abby Miranda. So Lexi Hickens exits the field defensively. One away for Gray Adams from the circle on that 4-3 putout. Bottom of the order in Erica Downey, who has been hit by a pitch and also has a ground out to the pitcher. Behind in the count, 0-1 is Downey. Fastball misses inside, 1-1. Erica Downey batting in the bottom of the order, the junior from Mercy Academy in Louisville, Kentucky. Lines one foul just wide of the third base bag. 2 multi-RBI games this year for Erica Downey, in fact, accounting for all of her 4 RBIs coming in. During her Mercy Academy career, Erica Downey, an honorable mention all-state selection as a junior. Grounds one to the right side for Hinton. Fields and throws to first again in time. 2 up, 2 down for Gray Adams in the top of the 6th inning. Back to the top of the order and Brenna Fink, who has a single, a run scored. It's also popped up to short and grounded out to first. First pitch from Adams, a called strike as the count, 0-1. Fink from Maroa, Illinois. Already 6 multi-hit games on the season, looking for her 7th if she can get a hit in this inning. Curveball outside, 1-1. Fink started every game as a freshman last year, hitting .254. Already 17 hits this year with a .486 average coming in. Called strike on the outside corner, 1-2. Well, Indiana and Iowa State are done for the day as far as the Samford UAB Classic. UAB will get their weekend underway here after the conclusion of this game. 1-2, fouled off to the left side. Taking a look at Murray State's schedule for at least the next few weeks. After this weekend, they'll go up to Carbondale, Illinois to face Northern Illinois, Western Illinois, UIC, and Southern Illinois. 1-2 just outside, 2-2. March 10th for the Racers will be the opening home day, the home opener against St. Louis as well as Austin Peay. And also the home weekend, the opening weekend at home, as a liner gets to the right side into right field for a base hit. So 2-for-4 on the day for Fink as she reaches with 2 outs. A solid start already for Murray State this year as they split 2 games in the opening weekend against Kent State, the defending MAC regular season champions. They have 2 wins over the 2016 Big East Tournament champion Butler Bulldogs last weekend down in Mobile. As to the plate, Kaylee Randberger gets ahead in the count 1-0. Two outs, top of the sixth inning. Pop up behind home plate, and that gets to the screen foul, 1-1. Samford with three errors so far today. Not a great performance, mind you, for Murray State so far. Mason Robinson has pitched well. But they've gotten the big hits and really just enough big plays to take a 4-0 lead in this one. Strike two, call as the count goes, 2-1-2. It's one of those where Murray State hasn't done anything to beat themselves in this one. They've kept themselves in it and have made enough plays to be able to take a comfortable lead. 1-2 is outside from Gray Adams as the count goes to 2-2. That's something a young Samford team will learn over time is, once again, like really a lot of the past couple of Samford teams, the 2015 and 16, and even the 2014 squad did very well as the liner up the middle gets through for the base hit. Fink and Ranberger with back-to-back singles put two runners on with two outs for Jessica Twaddle, who is 1-for-3 today. Remember last year, Samford, one of the best defensive teams, in fact, the best defensive team in the SoCon, didn't do a lot defensively to beat themselves. Of course, when you had Molly Hansen out there in the circle, you always had a chance to win no matter who the opponent was. Fly ball hit well, but that's going to hook foul and out of play. 0-1. As there's been a few games early on this season. A couple of errors in the eighth inning against Arkansas Pine Bluff that cost Samford a victory. The three unearned runs against Incarnate Word cost Samford a victory. And right now, Murray State has the upper hand in this one, but certainly three errors not helping Samford's cause in this one. 1-1 the count now on Twaddle. Two runners on. Fastball in there. 1-2. Fink at second, Ranberger over at first. A great crowd on opening day here at the campus of Samford University. Lazy fly ball into right field is going out. The second baseman Hinton makes the play, retires the side. And a good job by Gray Adams to work out of trouble. No runs, there were a couple of hits, no errors, and two left on base. So we go to the bottom of the sixth inning. It's 4-0 Murray State with the lead as you're watching Samford Softball on the Samford Sports Network.
At Express Oil Change and Tire Engineers, we believe in service.
Maintenance service, tire service, repair service.
And most importantly, customer service.
We believe in treating our customers with respect and integrity while offering all the services you need for your car.
Most of all, at Express Oil Change and Tire Engineers,
we believe in keeping cars on the road, keeping families safe,
and keeping you coming back whenever the need arises.
Home opener for the Samford Bulldogs today. Two games today. This is the second one. Samford already with a win earlier today. Still, they've already managed no worse than a split in their first two home games for the season, having defeated Iowa State 6-2 and in my mind, at Samford's all-around best game of the season. However, Samford needing to come back if they want to get two wins today, down 4-0 as we'll look at our scorecard as the 9-1-2 batters in the order, Royalty, Couch, and Mays do up. We'll have checked that Whitney Hinton coming up to the plate. Her first at bat of the doubleheader up in the count 1-0. Swings and lines it right at the third baseman on one hop. Throw across the diamond for Fink is in time. One away in the bottom of the sixth inning is Mason Robinson. Give her some credit. She's pitched very, very well and consistently so far in this one. Just two hits allowed, no runs, no walks, and no strikeouts that has allowed the pitch count to stay very low. Back to the top of the order in Madison Couch. And she's 0 for 2 and will take for ball one. The 1-0. Swung on and missed, 1-1. On deck is Shelby Mays. The wind and pitch. Lined opposite way is going back and making the catch is Kessel. Shy of the warning track in fair territory. Great defensive play that time, getting a good first step. As Madison Couch did a great job of hitting that time, going the opposite way. But Kessel did a better job that time of catching up to that fly ball and making the out. Shelby Mays has a single, one of two hits for Samford in this one. 1-for-2 on the afternoon in this one. Bunts it in front of home plate. That is a fair ball as Shelby Mays will get a bunt single. So the inning will continue for Samford as Mays with back-to-back singles. She's 2-for-3. Abby Sweeney to the plate looking for her first hit of the day. A ground out to third and a line out to second in this one. Takes the fastball from Robinson outside, 1-0. Like to get at least a couple of runs here if you're Samford to try and cut into this one and then put yourself in position for the bottom of the seventh inning. Granted, you can get a goose egg in the top of the seventh. Want to put at least some pressure on Murray State because Mason Robinson, she's pitched very consistently so far in this one. Strike call in the 1-0, 1-1. Outfield straight away. Swing and a miss by Sweeney, 1-2. We'll take a look at some of the other scores going around the SoCon. Also a tough time for Samford baseball down in Tallahassee in the series opener. 1-2 is outside, 2-2. Give you a Samford baseball update as Florida State whipping Samford 15-2 as they're in the bottom of the sixth inning. 2-2, lined softly but foul. Speaking of Samford baseball, they'll be in Tallahassee for the rest of the weekend for that three-game series, as you can find live stats, video, and more at sanfordsports.com. No audio from the Samford Sports Network for baseball this weekend, but the next baseball broadcast via Blake Gardner will be down at Auburn on Tuesday. Grounded to the right side, and that will be bobbled, and the throw is still in time. Give credit to Downey for the poise to be able to maintain control of the ball, keeping it in front of her, and then being able to throw to first. in time. So that'll do it for Samford offensively. No runs, one hit, no errors, and a runner left on base. Murray State maintains a 4-0 advantage as we go to the seventh inning on the Samford Sports Network.
These are the student athletes. This is where they train. These are their homes. This is where they become Rhodes Scholars and academic All-Americans. These are the athletes they've always admired. This is where champions are crowned and moments are made. This is the Southern Conference.
General Shale makes your great outdoors even better with big savings on its outdoor living collection. Everything you need to create your own backyard fire pit, outdoor fireplace, General Shale delivers to your home and can recommend a contractor. Or offers easy to follow instructions to do it yourself. Save money now on backyard fun with General Shale's complete outdoor living collection. Hurry, your great outdoors is waiting for you.
Second game of two today in the home schedule for your Samford Bulldogs. Samford wins game 1-6-2 over Iowa State, but trailing in game two to Murray State 4-0. James Hardy with you, looking around the SoCon as ETSU wins two today, 4-2 over Eastern Kentucky and 6-5 against Winthrop in the Winthrop Invitational. Western Carolina kickstarts their season today and wins two, 14-0 in five innings over Howard and 3-1 over Delaware State in the Buffalo Wild Wings Classic. Murray State will have the middle of their order as Taylor Odom takes low against Gray Adams. 1-0. Also, Furman winning two games in the Buffalo Wild Wings Classic. 1-0 over Toledo and 7-4 over Sacred Heart. 1-0 called a strike. The Buffalo Wild Wings Classic co-hosted by Furman and USC Upstate. Also, earlier this afternoon, Chattanooga falls in eight innings at home in the Frost Classic to Fairleigh Dickinson. The 1-1 drops low in the drop ball, 2-1. 8-7, Fairleigh Dickinson with the win over Chattanooga. One of the teams Samford beat last year up in the Big Apple last March. The 2-1 hits sharply but well foul, as Taylor Odom got way ahead of that one. 2-2. Mercer faces Savannah State as well as Marist today. They're leading Marist 2-0 or the Mercer Bears as the count goes to 3-2 with Odom taking the 2-2. Also, Chattanooga leading Northwestern State top the seventh, 5-2. 3-2 drops low for ball four as Taylor Odom reaches on the leadoff walk here in the seventh. Not an eye-popping performance for Murray State. Four runs, six hits, but no errors. A steady performance as they do have a two-run homer from Jocelyn Rogers, but otherwise, solid performance in the circle from Mason Robinson, as taking high on the rise ball is Jocelyn Rogers, who has really the big blow in this one, and that was the two-run, two-out homer in the fifth inning. The 1-0, bunted in front of home plate as Adams will field and throws. That's high off the glove of the first baseman. Spinks is moving ahead to third on what will be a sacrifice as Rogers, and also the fourth error of the game for Samford. Throw was a little bit high from the pitcher, Gray Adams, so looking to see. In fact, it, as I suspected, will be an error on Gray Adams, allowing Odom to get to third. So the infield will have to come in, nobody out. a 4-0 game as Murray State has a chance to blow this one open. Maggie Glass takes low, 1-0. Looking ahead to tomorrow across the SoCon. Samford will play at UAB against Murray State at 11 and also against Indiana about 30 minutes after that game as the 1-0 gets to the backstop, allowing Rogers to get to second. So runners now at second and third. That'll take the force option away at second base. First base open, but nobody out. Top of the seventh. All of the seven SoCon teams will be in action tomorrow. Check swing foul to our right and out of play. Check that to the left, right behind home plate. 2-1. Furman will take on Howard as well as Delaware State in the Buffalo Wild Wings Classic for a second day. ETSU battles Youngstown State and Bucknell in the Winthrop Invitational. The 2-1 low, 3-1. UNCG will open the weekend with George Washington as well as Longwood. And Western Carolina will take on USC Upstate and Toledo. Three-one pitch on the inside corner, 3-2. And Mercer faces IPFW as well as Savannah State in the Black and Orange Challenge. 3-2, fouled off left side. Murray State looking to get their day started in successful fashion. Up 4-0, two runners on as time is called. We were scoreless through three, and then an unearned run came across to score thanks to the Kayla Levin single in the fourth. A run scored on a throwing error by Shelby Mays in left in the fifth, followed by a two-run homer from Jocelyn Rogers as the payoff pitch misses for ball four. Bases loaded, nobody out for Kayla Levins. As Gray Adams is the second pitcher in this ball game for the Samford Bulldogs. Taylor DeCellis on the line, score 4 2/3 innings, 5 hits allowed, 4 runs given up, 3 earned with a walk and 3 strikeouts, and also a home run allowed. Gray Adams so far, an inning and a third, has allowed no runs on 2 hits with 3 walks and no strikeouts. However, the bases are loaded. Nobody out, top of the seventh inning, as the infield will come in to try and get the out at home. Kayla Levins 1-for-3 with an RBI. Takes a curveball in the outside corner, 0-1. Gray Adams has quite the assignment here, trying to minimize, if not try and stop the rally going here for Murray State. Odom at third, Rogers at second, and Maggie Glass over at first base. Pitch from Adams. Grounded up the middle and through for the base hit as one run will score and Odom. Rogers will stop at third as the bases will remain loaded as Murray State playing some musical bases with another RBI single for Levins and a 5-0 lead for the Racers. Rogers to third, Glass to second, and Levins over at first base.
The right fielder.
So Leah Kiesel, the right fielder to the plate, is 0-for-3 with a strikeout. A pop up to second and a ground out to second. 5-0 Murray State with the lead. Kiesel ahead in the count at 1-0. Takes low, 2-0. Bases are loaded. Do not see any activity still in the Samford bullpen as UAB warming up for their opening game at the weekend, as they'll face Murray State about 20 to 30 minutes. Check that. They'll play Indiana after this one. 3-0 is the count. Action will move down to UAB tomorrow before returning to the campus of Samford University to close out the weekend. It'll be UAB in Indiana scheduled for 5:30, the start time, but it'll be about 20 to 30 minutes after the conclusion of this one. 3-0, bases loaded for Kiesel, the right fielder. As she'll take the 3-0 for ball four, and that will bring home run number six of the game. The second of the inning as Rogers comes home to score. The first RBI for Kiesel on the day. Glass to third, Levins to second, and we'll have a new pitcher coming out as we'll take the timeout. 6-0 your score. Murray State with the lead on the Samford Sports Network.
The road to Omaha begins in Greenville, South Carolina. The Southern Conference Baseball Tournament comes to Fluor Field May 23rd through 28th. Enjoy some great college baseball with a trip to the NCAAs on the line in a city the New York Times calls one of the top places to go in 2017. Get your tickets to the tournament and book your rooms in that Greenville today. Experience the games. Explore the city.
I think we should have taken a left at the river.
Tarzan, no. Where Tarzan go?
Tarzan does not know where Tarzan go.
Hey, excuse me. Do you know where the waterfall is? Waterfall?
No, no. Me, Tarzan. King of jungle.
Why don't you want to just...
If you're a couple, you fight over directions. It's what you do. If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to Geico. It's what you do.
You have to do that right in my ear.
Senior Jessica Stone comes out to the circle for the first time on the day. The senior from Moody will make her fourth appearance of the season, an 0-2 record with a 5.73 ERA, inherits the bases loaded with nobody out as Erica Downey will take for strike one. Jessica Stone has pitched 11 innings this year, allowed 14 hits, 12 runs, of which 9 earned, with 8 walks and 4 strikeouts. Foul ball our way, 0-2 the count. Jessica Stone has allowed 2 home run balls so far this season, a .298 average that opposing hitters have against Jessica Stone. 0-2. Grounded back to Stone. She'll knock it down and doesn't have a play. She's not able to get a handle of the softball. Is coming home to score will be Glass. Levins to third. Kiesel to second. So you'd have to rule that a hit, as that'll be an RBI for Erica Downey. Cannot assume the out at home in any case, as that'll be run number 7 of the game. Back to the top of the order, and Brenna Fink with a foul ball to the left side. Fink 2-for-4 with a pair of singles, a run scored, as well as a pop-up to short and a ground out to first. The 0-1. Inside for ball one. A scoreless game through the first 3 innings, and then Murray State has exploded, and another run will come home to score. As on the last at bat, they did credit Erica Downey with a single. So the runners on base will advance to second and third. Kiesel to third and Downey to second. as before the 0-1 as it misses for ball one. Maggie Glass will score from third. A balk was called that allowed Levens to score. Fastball high, 2-1. So four runs in the inning. Fourth run on the balk from Jessica Stone, her first of the season. The 2-1. Fouled back to the screen, 2-2. So what turned out to be a great opening home game for Samford in game one has turned into a somewhat disappointing finish, at least right now, as we still are in the top of the seventh inning with Samford trailing Murray State by a score of 8-0. 2-2 the count. The Racers looking to continue the rally here. Still nobody out and a pair of runners in scoring position for the leadoff batter in Fink. 2-2. Tapped left side for Couch as she'll throw to first base in time. Good job by Madison Couch that time to check the runner at third before throwing to first. So one out. Runners remain at second and third for Kaylee Randberger, who is 1-for-4. A strikeout, a line out to center. Also a batter's interference in the fifth. And also a single in the sixth inning. First pitch strike to Randberger. 0-1 the count. Murray State ought to be a pretty competitive squad from what we've seen so far today. An experienced, rock-solid pitcher in Mason Robinson. That's a four-year starter for the Racers. Has proven herself in the OVC as Stone gets ahead in the count 0-2. They can get enough hitting, ought to be able to compete, certainly in the upper tier of the OVC this season. 0-2. Fastball high, 1-2. Kaylee Randberger with her fifth at-bat of the ball game. Looking to go to 9-2 on the year. It's called strike three as Jessica Stone gets her first strikeout as she paints the outside corner, two away. Randberger, a true freshman getting the start, already four multi-hit games coming in. Has a hit today. The freshman from Owensboro, Kentucky is Jessica Twaddle. Another experienced player, a senior to the plate, as she'll take a changeup for strike one from Jessica Stone. Twaddle, a single and a run scored in the fifth inning, has grounded out two times and popped up, but once. Leaving the count at 1-1 as she'll take outside. Twaddle from Franklin, Tennessee, OVC Player of the Year two seasons ago in 2015. Also a third-team All-Mideast Region by NFCA. That season, .426 the batting average with 54 RBIs and 8 home runs. So definitely some pieces to work with for Murray State, a lot of experience with 9 starters returning from last year as the count goes to 2-2. Two outs. Runners at second and third. The 2-2 from Stone lined off of the glove of Spinks down the right field line as two runs will come home to score. Getting it back in will be Higgins and Wright as the two runs score 6 in the inning and now 10-0 in favor of Murray State. Kiesel scores from third. Downey comes home from second. As Taylor Odom will get her second at bat of the inning. A hot shot past Carson Spinks over at first is a high fly ball down the left field line. That's foul by about a few feet over the left field monster. Odom with her second at bat from Gorville, Illinois. Still looking for her first hit of the ball game. 10 of 25 coming into the weekend. Takes the off-speed pitch high. 1-1. The last at-bat, by the way, for Twaddle scored a double, so two RBIs for her. Taylor Odom now ahead in the count, 2-1. 10 hits for the Racers on 10 runs with no errors. No runs, 3 hits, 4 errors for the Bulldogs of Samford University. Drop ball low, 3-1. 2 outs, so the runner at second base in Twaddle will go on contact. Pitch on the way. Fly ball into right field. Well hit for Odoms. That nearly clears the yard as it hits high off the wall. Coming home to score will be Twaddle to make it 11-0. Totally different type of ball game over the last few innings than we saw certainly to start out almost the first half of the ball game, as it was anybody's ball game going into the fifth inning. But since the fifth, Murray State has put 10 runs on the board and now have 11 for the game. So Odom with a double and an RBI. A touchdown on the board in the seventh inning for Murray State as a grounder up the middle to Hinton as she'll field. Throws to first in time, and the inning mercifully comes to an end. So for Murray State, in the seventh inning, they put 7 on the board to take an 11-0 lead as we go to the bottom of the seventh inning here on the Samford Sports Network. Abby Miranda, Hannah Trombley, and Lauren Lewis will come up to the plate to try and get things going as Samford down 11-0 in the second of two games this afternoon. Home opening date for the red, white, and blue of Samford U as they've already put a win on the board on the home schedule over Iowa State 6-2, but struggling in late innings in this one against Murray State. Scoreless through three. They were still in it, down 1-0 going to the fifth inning, but Murray State scored 3 in the fifth inning and then put 7 on the board so far to put this one away.
Leading off for the Bulldogs, the second baseman, Abby Miranda.
Samford, at the very minimum, looking to build some momentum into tomorrow where they will face Murray State and Indiana, with games being played at UAB tomorrow. As Mason Robinson wants to get the complete game, as she gets strike one on Abby Miranda. The 0-1 misses on the fastball, 1-1. Miranda swings and loops it into center field where Randberger comes in on a few steps and makes the catch. Abby Miranda 0-for-3. Unlike game one where Samford just about clicking on all cylinders, far from it in this one. Just three hits, no runs, 11 runs given up, and also four errors in the field. So definitely a dichotomy of the performances today between game one and game two. Trombley will take strike one, also looking for her first hit. Hits today belonging by Kelsey Royalty as well as two from Shelby Mays. The 0-1 just misses high, 1-1. Both Indiana and UAB awaiting to take the field for the final game of the day in the Samford-UAB Classic. Swing and a miss, 1-2. Curveball by Mason Robinson. Gray Adams was solid from the circle in game one, but just as she has been solid, so has Mason Robinson from Murray State. Weak grounder to the right side. Fielded and stepping on the back, Twaddle over at first base. Two up and two down in the seventh inning. Mason Robinson working on that complete game. Three hits allowed, has not walked or struck out a batter. Don't see that very often, but also it's kind of the pitcher's best friend in just limiting the pitch count and limiting the time your defense spends on the field as the first pitch is a strike called. Lauren Lewis at the plate. Two hits against Iowa State along with two RBIs. 0-for-2 so far. The 0-1 strike call as Samford down to their final strike. 11-0, the Murray State Racers with the lead looking to finish this one off. 0-2. That misses low, 1-2. Carson Spinks is on deck if the game continues. We'll have a recap of this one, as well as the recap of the day, and a look at scores from around the SoCon. Grounder foul wide of the third base bag. A good win for Samford in game one, but not such a good performance in this one. One and two the count. Foul ball to the right side. Something you see often from young teams looking to find their way and find an identity. You'll have a great performance on one night and not such a good performance on another. Tapper foul to the left side. Looking at a lot of pieces still looking to be filled from last year's run, really from the last 3 years as well. You're talking over 100 wins for Samford in the last 3 years. Grounder to the left side. This should do it. It's Glassfields and throws to first in time, and that's your ball game. Samford goes down quietly in the seventh inning. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left on base. As Murray State finishes the game impressively, scoring 7 in the top of the seventh inning, but a solid complete game outing for Mason Robinson, despite not striking out a batter, did not walk a batter, allows only three hits in picking up the win. Taylor DeSellis with the loss in this one falls to 1-3, and Mason Robinson off to a really good start this year from the circle. The senior for Murray State up to 7-1, the record on the year. We'll take the timeout. 11-0 your final as Murray State defeats Samford University. We'll take the timeout and begin our postgame after this on the Samford Sports Network.
This is Lauren. These are her first roommates, her first car, and her very first health insurance plan, Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama. Even at her age, she's not taking her health for granted. Her affordable health plan includes a routine annual checkup, apps, and programs that fit her lifestyle. Lauren may be just starting out, but with us,
she's already got peace of mind. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama. We cover what matters. Find out how we can cover you for the...
Hi, I'm John I. Marino, Commissioner of the Southern Conference. With the full cooperation of our presidents and chancellors, the conference has created the SOCON Academic Exchange, a cooperative structure designed to benefit our academic efforts. Three primary initiatives will be the collaboration of international study programs, a leadership development program to benefit faculty and staff, and an undergraduate research forum. For more information on the SOCON Academic Exchange, visit soconsports.com.
Samford splits their first two home games of the season, beating Iowa State 6-2, but falling by a score of 11-0 to Murray State as we get our final totals. James Hardy with you on the Samford Sports Network via our YouTube stream for today. 11 runs, 11 hits, no errors for Murray State. No runs, 3 hits, and 4 errors for the red, white, and blue of Samford U. A home run for Jocelyn Rogers. For Murray State, as Mason Robinson pitches a complete game, allows just 3 hits, no walks, and no strikeouts, and picking up win number 7 on the season for her. Taylor DeCellis starts the game, goes 4 2/3, allows 5 hits, 4 runs, 3 of those earned with a walk and 3 strikeouts. Gray Adams comes in relief, 1 3rd innings pitched, allowed 3 hits, 5 runs, of which 3 were earned with 4 walks and no strikeouts. Jessica Stone comes in for the final inning of play. Gives up 3 hits, 2 runs, none earned, with no walks and 1 strikeout. From the plate, 2 hits allowed by Shelby Mays. 2 hits for Shelby Mays offensively and 1 hit for Kelsey Royalty. But that's all the offensive production in this one. As for Murray State, a solid team outing from the plate. Brenna Fink with 2 hits. Jessica Twaddle with a couple of hits. Jocelyn Rogers with 2 hits, including the home run. Kayla Levins also with a couple of hits. And 2 RBIs each for Levins, Rogers, and Jessica Twaddle. Time the ball game right at 2 hours with 311 in attendance for the second game of the Samford doubleheader today. Indiana and UAB getting ready for their twin bill. We may have head coach Mandy Burford on for the post game. A little under the weather today, so if she doesn't make it, certainly understandable. But we'll find out here in a few moments. Checking around the SoCon, though, as far as our scores for today. ETSU wins twice, 4-2 over Eastern Kentucky and 6-5 over Winthrop. Western Carolina kicks off the season in solid fashion, 14-0 over Howard and 3-1 over Delaware State from Spartanburg, South Carolina. Furman with 2 wins today, 1-0 over Toledo and 7-4 over Sacred Heart. Fairleigh Dickinson defeats Chattanooga up in Chattanooga for the Frost Classic, 8-7. And in the second game against Northwestern State, they get a 5-3 victory over Northwestern State. So like Samford, Northwest Chattanooga, rather, splits the doubleheader. And also UNCG idol today. And for the Mercer Bears in their game against Marist, so far up 3-0 over Marist as they're in the top of the fourth inning in the Black and Orange Challenge from Macon, Georgia. Also taking a look at Samford baseball as they're underway with the series opener at Florida State. Trailing is Samford 16-3 over number 5 Florida State. Bottom of the 8th inning from Tallahassee. Samford baseball will get underway tomorrow and Sunday at noon Central Time down in Tallahassee. So you can find full coverage of that on SanfordSports.com. No audio for that one from the Samford perspective, but Blake Gardner will be back behind the mic for Samford baseball Tuesday as the Bulldogs make the trip down to Auburn to face the Tigers out of the Southeastern Conference on Tuesday night. And also a big night for Samford basketball tomorrow. A doubleheader at the Pete Hanna Center for men's and women's basketball as Coach Mike Morris's squad will have senior night tomorrow in their regular season finale as they'll host Mercer at 2 o'clock. Well, Scott Padgett's Samford Bulldogs will host the Citadel Bulldogs at 6 o'clock from the Pete Hanna Center, also senior night for the men as they'll close out the season on Monday at Mercer. We'll take the timeout, and after the timeout, we'll wrap it up and set up the scene for the rest of the weekend here on the Samford Sports Network.
Discovering new things is good. For example, you may discover that the best bank in town isn't a bank.